Please do not forget to comment, like, share, and subscribe so you can see more awesome, funny, crazy Alaskan content that might just be possibly related to survival, bushcraft, and EDC. And without any further ado, guys, let's jump right into this actual video. Okay, guys, so awkward and hilarious intro aside, and as I like to do kind of here in the early springtime, I kind of like to try and chip away some of the ice off this table so I can put stuff on it. But today we are going to be taking a look at, like what I said, two different lighters, or like the title said, two different lighters. And we're going to be comparing, contrasting, and kind of talking about some of the reasons why I switched over to a Maritak peanut lighter as opposed to a good old-fashioned Zippo lighter like this one. And this is going to be basically what we're talking about today. And now let's jump into it. So guys, hopefully you enjoy this kind of mixture of being able to see me and being able to see my stuff, or the stuff that I'm talking about today. And I'm trying to, as you guys have requested many a time, get you guys a little bit closer to the table so you guys can see the stuff a little bit better. Of course, it's a little bit hard because of all the snow, but I want to try and show you guys the stuff and myself in the video and actually it be seeable. So anyways, like I was gonna say, this is the Maritak peanut lighter. Now this is the XL version. This is the anodized aluminum XL version of the peanut lighter. They come in multiple different types and different styles. They come in titanium, brass, different sizes, but I personally really like the XL size because it's the closest size to the actual Zippo. And you can see with this little knob up here, it's a little bit taller, but as far as the actual area of holding stuff or holding fluid, they're about the same size. Of course, the Zippo can hold a little bit more because this is a round cylinder as opposed to this kind of square. So the Zippo ends up holding just a little bit more, but not too much more as far as fuel capacity goes. And I think personally, with the ability that this has to actually hold it, like hold the lighter fluid you put in it, as opposed to a Zippo lighter where they kind of run out over the course of time and they just kind of naturally evaporate, I think it's easily matched. So, like I said, today this is what we're going to be talking about, and overall why I kind of made the switch to the peanut lighter. So I think the largest reason, and honestly I've tried to really get Zippos because I love the Zippo style, and personally I kind of like the Zippo as far as holding it goes a little bit more than the peanut lighter because it feels more substantial in hand due to the overall shape of it. It feels like you can get a better grip on it. And oh, it's going. You guys might not be able to see the flame, but I do promise this one is going. But so you can get a better grip on it. And overall, I like the way these things work. They're very tough, rugged, and reliable lighters so long as they have fluid in them. They're overall pretty resilient. Aside from getting wet, they're pretty resilient, just like most kind of lighters that are in the similar style. So that's overall this lighter, and I do really love Zippos. And once again, I did put a Ranger band on all the Zippos I have that I use frequently and have to help kind of keep the fluid in them. However, this still isn't quite enough, and for me personally, I'm more of a survivalist. I use my lighters not for smoking, but for survival, starting fires. And what I continually ran into and what I didn't like was kind of the almost, especially if you're using these for survival, the kind of danger of grabbing your lighter out of your pocket and it not striking a flame. Now of course, these both have been recently refueled and will strike a flame every time you strike them, but The whole issue with the Zippo is, even with this Ranger Band, while the Ranger Band does increase the life of the Zippo that you have or the amount of fuel you put in it, it still is not perfect by any means, and it does drain out eventually. And so the primary reason why I swapped over to the peanut lighter was so that I didn't have to worry about that. Now, for those who aren't familiar with the peanut lighter, these do use a solid O-ring here down at the base. So when you close them up and you screw them tight like this, they're absolutely airtight, they're waterproof, they're everything you need them to be. And so that makes the peanut lighters inherently more or better for survival situations, because you never have to question if this peanut lighter is going to have fluid in it. So it's not going to drain its fluid, and once again, it's not going to allow water to come in and spoil your wick. So that is a really nice thing, and that's once again the primary reason why I went over to the peanut lighter. Now, I will say, when you do go over to any peanut lighter of any size, you do have to give up the ergonomics and the fuel capacity that a Zippo has, so the Zippo can hold a little bit more fluid. And once again, as we've been over, the ergonomics, and at least in my opinion, the ergonomics on the Zippo are a bit better than that of the peanut lighter, and it's just overall more fluid to strike, more fluid to hold. Now, I will note another advantage that I kind of found to the peanut lighter is, and this is kind of another survival perk to it, is that if you're trying to light things, and oftentimes this is something that I would run into with the Zippo in just practicing lighting fires with it and stuff, if you're trying to get a flame, like say you start it and you're trying to get a flame into a really close or really confined place, the peanut lighter will be significantly better, because when these are opened and lit like this, you have to, if you're trying to get into a place or you're trying to light something in particular, you have to deal with this little door here, and this door honestly nearly doubles the width when open. It doubles like the width of the Zippo, so it's actually kind of hard to get it into a confined spot and actually light a fire with it, like I said, like this. So whereas with this peanut lighter, because the top of it detaches completely from the actual lighter itself, if you need to get into a place, you have a really small and really easily maneuverable piece to get into a place. Not to mention, as well, the actual overall ergonomics of these two lighters, like the actual bodies of these lighters. This peanut lighter is far more slender and, once again, far more easy to get into places. So that was something I did enjoy about the peanut lighter, because it's just a far easier to actually start things with. And once again, you don't have to question whether or not it's going to have fuel. So those are the two, I think, really primary reasons why I went over to a peanut lighter. I liked the improved ergonomics. I liked the fact that I didn't have to worry about the water or water getting in. I didn't have to worry about it evaporating. And also, I also like the ease at which you can carry these. These are a little bit more versatile to carry, peanut lighter. You can throw these. This just right now has just a really simple snake knot, because generally I don't really have any keychains. I don't really rock a keychain, but so I just throw this in my pocket, and so I just have a lanyard on it so I can find it in my pocket and grab it out. But if you did want to, you can also put these on keychains. They're very easy to carry, and I think that's another nice thing about, once again, going back to survival, is, you know, having something on you. Obviously, the best survival tools you have, or the best survival tools you can have, are the ones that you are going to have on you day after day. And so I think, you know, if you want, like, to rock things on a, or on a keychain or something along those lines, this is a very easy one to just throw on a keychain. Obviously, you cannot throw this on a keychain, but this is also something easy and smaller in overall profile that you can throw in your pocket, forget about it, and just have that lighter on you, which once again is really important for survival, because you really want to make sure that whatever tool you're going to carry for survival, you actually have on you. So advantages over to this. So those are some of the primary reasons why I really honestly love the little peanut lighters by Maritak. And going over to Zippos, they definitely are great lighters, and I do like the whole fact that, once again, this is kind of like one of those pros and cons thing, that to the defense of the Zippo, it is nice that the lid is attached to the actual lighter itself, because then you don't have to worry about losing it. And another thing that, one of the things you'll notice when I'm putting this lighter out, oftentimes you'll see me just blow it out like that, but that's because, especially when this thing is blazing away with a flame, it's kind of hard and a little bit dangerous to actually put this thing on fast enough without having the flame hit your fingers itself. So it can be a little bit hard to actually cap the peanut lighters, and so to actually extinguish the flame, because that's generally how you're supposed to do it. But I just generally get in there and just blow it out really hard. You can do the same thing with a Zippo too. With a Zippo, it's really easy to just flip over its top to it. And now it's not easy for me to do it, but you know, it's really easy to just flip over the top on it. So they kind of have that trade-off, but either way, I do like that to a degree. Once again, it is also kind of an obstruction though when you are going to light things, and especially when you're working and trying to light smaller little like tinder bundles, it can be harder to do with a Zippo lighter. So So other than that, like I said, the Zippo does have its advantage in the fact that so long as you're actually using it a lot, the Zippo does actually hold more fuel. Another thing that is nice about the Zippos is, and I actually tried this out and wouldn't fully recommend it, because over time, the flints do actually, I found, disintegrate if you do put a flint or a ferrocerium little bit in there. So do be mindful of that. But a nice survival trick you can use is putting flints in the actual back here. So you kind of have added storage capacity. However, do keep in mind that if you do that, you want to take the flints out before you fill it, because one time I just experimented and I put like 3 flints in the back here, and then I filled it and filled it and filled it, and then I checked like a few months later, and most of the flints, or like the flints themselves, were mostly disintegrated. So do keep that in mind, that the lighter fluid will disintegrate the flints. Just keep that in mind. But anyways, that is a nice thing that the Zippos have to them. And other things I would recommend to either of these lighters is, I would strongly recommend keeping in your survival kit or even your EDC. Zippo actually makes some really cool different accessories where you can carry extra flints, and they also have spare canisters, which are watertight canisters, or airtight, I should say, canisters of fluid. You can fill them up. And I would definitely recommend carrying something like that for either of these, because regardless to whether or not your lighter evaporates fluid or it doesn't, at some point you are going to run out of fluid, regardless to which method you use or which lighter you use. They're going to run out of fluid at some point, so you should try and have some extra fluid, like an extra shot of fluid, with you, just to help you continue to have that flame. So that would be something that I definitely recommend as an extra to either of them. But definitely the reason why I switched over to the Maritac, and honestly, ever since I switched over, I have not gone back to the Zippos. Not to say that the Zippo lighter is a bad lighter, but just that it just continues to lose fluid too frequently for me, and I oftentimes forget about it, and you know, forget to put more fluid in it, so it can kind of run dry frequently. So I like the Maritac more for that reason the most. And so anyways, guys, hopefully you've enjoyed this video, ton of talking about these two lighters, and hopefully you enjoy this closer up. I am trying to bring the camera closer. It's just a little bit harder to do. But anyways, guys, that's all for now. God bless, and I'm out.